see what I've been up to this summer? Find out as I reveal my most intimate...
Oh, my God!
...in private moments in my very own video diary.
Mama!
So join me as I work a lot.
I used to think...
Play a little...
Okay, I'm done! I'm done! I'm done. No!
...but always have quality time with my favorite people. My summer ends as I take the stage at the 2001 Video Music Awards. But before then, you'll see that I'm living on my own and on my own terms.
I look like a bad ass.
And I can't wait to show you what I'm all about.
Y'all are such a dork. I'm a dork.
You think you know, but you have no idea. This is the Diary of Britney Spears. June 14th, 2001. Summer 2001 has been really one of the best years and one of the hardest too.
You have to do that second Pepsi commercial. Then we do the Vogue shoot.
I've accomplished so much in the past year. I've done a movie, I've done an album that I'm really, really proud of. But at the same time, it's been really hard.
I'm overwhelmed. Okay, chill down.
I think I'm going through this transitional stage in my life where I'm just really figuring out what Britney wants and really just who I am.
I know, I'm a princess.
Having a house by yourself, it's just that, I don't know, that independent feeling of like, you know, I'm living on my own and my parents aren't here, you know? You just start feeling more confident, start feeling like I'm in more control of what I do. It's a cool feeling, it is.
I'm not a very good driver, okay? I'll admit, I'm not.
I'm thinking I'm in my own world.
Oh, God, man.
Wherever I go, usually I have a driver that drives me around. And trust me, I love my drivers, but I love to drive by myself. It's just the feeling of being in your car and you're driving or with the top down and just listening to music. And, you know, it just makes me think of how I was when I used to be back home.
What?
Hi, hello.
A picture? We're driving, girl.
You turned the radio down, you went,
huh?
I feel like sometimes I forget that I'm like a celebrity. I'm like, hey.
I just filmed a movie, which I'm really, really proud of. It's not just a Hollywood movie, it's real. And it was very cool. It was a cool experience for me.
Good morning.
I've always been a drama queen. So I definitely knew that acting was something that I eventually wanted to do.
Yeah, let's hear it one more time.
Looping is not very fun. When you were filming the movie, all the parts when you were, you know, when you were talking really, really quiet, you have to go in and redo it and match it up. The movie's about these three young girls finding themselves and, bottom line, just girls sticking with each other. You know, when your boyfriend breaks up with you, what do? You call your girlfriend, you know, and I just love that positive message in that. The love scene. I don't want to talk about it. No, it's just, it doesn't mean anything. It's all acting. It doesn't mean anything, but it's awkward, you know? The reason why I was shocked when I was watching it is because it's very realistic.
Oh my God.
You're sitting there and you're watching, you're like, oh, I did not do that. I did. Well, Justin, he was in town visiting me. Actually, he was doing a little recording himself. So he decided to pop in and surprise me.
Hello?
Leave my boyfriend alone.
Hey.
I was really excited to see him, but I was kind of nervous and quiet because he hasn't seen any of the movie yet.
I look stupid, see what I mean?
Going out tonight, I'm feeling alright.
No, there's supposed to be music right now.
Everything that I do, I always ask him, you know, what he thinks and stuff like that because I love him, so of course it means everything to me. But he liked it.
See you guys later.
Bye-bye.
Hey. We've known each other since we were like 12 years old.
Guys, I want to see my boyfriend. Y'all have a great night.
You know, and when we saw each other, like 5 years after that, it was just like sparks.
I totally believe, like, when you find the right person, you just know. You know what I mean? And you just know, and it can't last forever.
I definitely, in the future, I would love to be with him forever. I would. That night was really special because, first of all, I haven't had my mom's cooking in a really long time. And it's nice going to restaurants and stuff like that. Don't get me wrong, you know, the food's great, but there's just something about your mom's home cooking. My cousin Laurelyn was there, and my Aunt Sandra was there.
Why am I talking to each other?
It was all the people that I really love.
Oh, Mama made it so pretty.
So I was really excited.
Hey, Mommy, you gonna fix me some?
My little sister, Jamie Lynn. Oh, my goodness. She is, Miss Diva.
Jamie Lynn, since when do you call Mama Mommy?
Jamie
Mommy!
You said it because I wanted something.
World, better watch out when she comes because she is crazy.
Shut up! No, they do not,
Jamie Lynn. Yes, they do!
Yes, we always have that much fun, and they always end up ganging up on me. I don't know why they do that.
Yo, stanky booty.
Shut up.
But they always end up picking on me, and it irritates me sometimes. Dustin, I don't know what it is. I guess because from the Mickey Mouse Club, his mom and my mom, they were always really, really close and really good friends.
Mama.
Like, it's like a second mom to me, his mom. And I think it's vice versa.
I just want to say, any ideas and thoughts expressed by the Spears family aren't necessarily thoughts expressed by anyone of the Timberlake family.
You know, we just feel really comfortable with each other. So, and our families too. So that's a blessing. You know, but you have no idea. This is the diary of Britney Spears. June 20th, 2001.
But here
now
you go.
Well, I was in New York recording with Max Martin on the song I'm Not a Girl that goes with my movie.
I have the answers to everything.
Oh, okay.
Okay? Not too much on any answers.
Okay. I know, but I start thinking I want to be the confident. Like, I'm
yeah,
confident.
I know.
Max is very mellow. You come in, you know, he plays you the song and you go in and you just sing it down. You know, he's very cool, just mellow, cool guy to hang out with.
This is from years of sitting in front of the computer. Right. This is what you get.
Max Martin, he's the guy who writes all the wonderful pop songs in this world. He's amazing. I don't know what it is. I guess just the simplicity of the way he writes songs. I don't know, but what he does, it seems to work. The melodies, you can't get them out of your head. And he's cool. He's a very cool guy, very unassuming. The song is called Not a Girl, and it's basically talking about, you know, I'm not a girl, but I'm not yet a woman. You're just in that transitional stage in your life where you're just figuring yourself out. And something that I can definitely relate to.
Life doesn't always go my way, yeah.
Life doesn't always.
Can you do that?
Always.
I'm definitely at a stage in my life where I'm starting to realize with everyone, because of how young I am, they feel like they have to take care of me.
Serious focus, Britney.
And they mean well, and that's really, really nice, but there is a point in your life where you want to feel like you're in control, and it's up to you to stand up and to let them know that.
No.
And that's what I'm doing. I'm telling them that I'm not a little girl anymore.
I'm not a girl, don't tell me.
finished an album. And just the fact that I wrote all the songs except two is something that I'm really proud of, you know? I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, because it's like you're putting your heart out there for the whole world to see.
Yay! This sounds hard.
It's been something that I'm really proud of, and I hope people like it.
June 28th, 2001.
Ooh, yeah, I have some hair. Oh, my makeup
looks
pretty.
Duffy, don't forget your underwear and bra for your date, okay? Right.
This is what Felicia, Britney's assistant, is wearing on her date tonight.
And that's all. That's all.
I had 3 days to do publicity shots for my album. One of the days was with her, Brits. No, I've worked with him before on my video shoot, Don't Let Me Be the Last to Know. I love his work, and I think, honestly, he brings out the best in people.
That's a shot. Give me the camera quick, Eric.
Taking photos, it's about being really comfortable and just capturing that special moment. When I do photo shoots, I'm not like, well, I want it to be this kind of look or that kind of look, you know? I talk to my stylist, and I tell them what I want the clothes to look like, and he just captures that.
Britney Spears. I have a little crush on Britney.
Reese Witherspoon said something really flattering.
I think she's really cute. I mean, there's just something so appealing about her. The whole outfit, the hair, the dancing. It's just the entire package.
I like
her. She said that about me.
Yeah.
It was really sweet that she said that. So thank you. That was really nice. Thanks. That made my day.
Drive.
My favorite look that day was probably the jeans, and I had like a simple shirt on. Because it was more, it was the most comfortable.
Hell yeah, baby.
As long as I have music, then I'm sitting there dancing and I can be in my own little world and he can capture that, you know. So it was fun. I don't really look at myself as a sex symbol. Ah, no, I don't at all.
What it feels like, Becca.
It's very flattering, you know, that people say that and they think that, but when I'm on stage, it's my time to express myself and to go there, you know, and to dance and just lose all composure. But when I'm off the stage, I'm just me and I'm dork. Such a dork.
See you guys.
July 7th, 2001.
Hi. Good morning, so I don't feel like talking really.
I was the Grand Marshal for the NASCAR in Daytona.
She's gonna be doing that, so we're gonna be touch up when they're gonna hit.
As far as like going to events and stuff like that, where I know it's gonna be crazy, I have, you know, Felicia with me and Rob with me to take care of me, okay, and to protect me. Oh, Felicia, I don't know what I would do without her.
Thank you, no, you have no idea.
She is heaven sent.
Point, and I go every time. They're pointing you. They're pointing you. And you would go, no, he's not.
She's the bad guy for me. Like when people come up to me and start annoying me and like wanting this, wanting that, I just say, Fee, come here. And she takes care of me.
And y'all were like, go, Fee. You're so tough.
Big Rob, I would never would have thought this, but he's like my best friend.
I like your shirt, Rob.
What?
Your baby blue in today.
We hang out, we go out, we go clubbing, and he's just funny. God has really blessed me with the team of people that I'm able to have around me. I am so blessed.
Thank you.
I really am.
The water!
When we first got there, I walked out and I was like, where's Mama at? You know, where are they at?
Oh,
I'm trying to see if I see Mama.
And I was like, wouldn't it be cool if we saw them? You know, if we saw them and they start waving and stuff. And
where?
As soon as I said that, my mom spotted us from being up there. And she was like, hey, what's up? It's really funny. We have like this connection. Like right before I call her, she's like, Brittany, I was just about to call you. We're very connected like that.
Okay, on her.
So I was really happy to see them. I was like, hey, come up here, please.
Happy birthday.
It had been like 4 or 5 weeks since I'd seen my dad.
Lewis's birthday, and we had a big party, and it was fun. I had a lot of fun. I got my dad a bracelet for his birthday to match his watch.
You like it?
Nice.
I like it. I love it, girl. What sister got me for my birthday?
Is that real?
She said, is that real, Daddy?
Gosh. Of course, Daddy.
Let's skip the race. Daddy, you can go do this. Gentlemen, start your engines. I'll go out on.
My outfit for NASCAR, I have to say, was very cool.
I control.
Look at my outfit.
My stylist, Kurt and Bart, they really hooked me up. I felt like a badass. And the glasses totally topped it off.
I look like a badass.
Where's Jim?
I look like I'm about to tear up somebody.
One of the hardest things about this business is just being away from my family and my little sister so much. You know, I just feel bad sometimes because she's growing up and I feel like I'm missing moments that I really want to be there for.
Come here. Got you.
Family comes before everything. I'm just so blessed. I thank God every day for my family.
Hold on. Yeah, we want to take care of the race fan here.
Hey, listen, I'll tell you, it is the greatest birthday I've ever had.
Oh, okay.
He was like, this has been the best birthday I've ever had. I was like, oh, good. Lance was there because a lot of his friends are from there. Justin wasn't there that day because his family was in Orlando. He just wanted to go golfing with his dad and just spend some time with his family. I had no idea. There was so many people. And I walked in there and I looked down and they were screaming and I was like, oh, hi. First, I didn't think it was gonna be on television. And then when they told me, I was like, oh, okay, that's cool, all right.
Bo, is the welcome on TV?
Yeah.
Oh, is the welcome in?
Wait,
have
they seen it?
Yes.
They did?
They probably will.
Okay, I wanna welcome.
And let's start your interview.
Be Bo.
Oh, yeah, definitely. There's like a lot of people, man.
It was a lot of fun for me because usually when I do things like that, I have to perform or, you know, be on stage.
Can't pick your nose.
Okay, I'll try not to pick my nose.
All right.
Can't poop.
I just got to go and say, gentlemen, start your engines.
Let's go. Ready?
For some reason, I was so nervous just to say, gentlemen, start your engines. I do not know why.
And now for the most famous words in motorsports, the Grand Marshal of the 43rd Hampshire 400 Daytona, Miss Brandy Spears.
Start your engines!
It was really cool when me and my dad, we got to ride in the car.
You think you know, but you have no idea. Oh my God, here we go. Y'all, we're about to go. We are, Danny.
It was really weird. We go like this, and you don't realize how fast you're going. And the thing is completely sideways. I was like, oh my gosh, I didn't realize these people go through this.
Oh my God.
But it was a really special moment for my dad because, I don't know, it was his birthday and he was with me. It made me happy, so happy that he was happy. July 18th, 2001. Since I've been recording, I haven't really been training that much. You know, I'm about to start doing the tour and stuff like that, and I have to be physically fit, otherwise I'm gonna go crazy.
We're making her lean, we're making her mean, fit, and buff. Get the muscles warmed up by bringing, circulating the blood.
When I was like 12 years old, I was the coordinator for the aerobics class at my dad's gym. So it's something that I don't think of something that I have to do when I go and I work out. It's something that I honestly, I enjoy doing.
So she's going down, she's crunching, and trying to get this the sides here all toned up and tight.
Get this fat off my abs!
Yeah, that fat, right?
I'm all about sit-ups. I love doing sit-ups. I probably do like 500 sit-ups. Yeah.
here's the kicker here. This works the lower stomach, the lower abdomen.
And if I'm having a really good day, I'll do like probably 1,000. When I get up in the morning and I work out, I have more energy throughout the day. I just feel better about myself. July 28, 2001.
Wake up.
I was in Vegas for the weekend because I was doing a charity event, and it ended up seriously being like a vacation.
We're in Vegas right now for NSYNC's Challenge for the Children, and my family's here, my friends are here, my brother, and we're about to go ride roller coasters. Yeah.
It's very rare that my brother and me and my cousin were all at the same place. I love my brother. He's put me through a lot, but I still love him. He used to always pick on me and tell my mom I was doing things when I wasn't.
Oh, yours either.
Like Darth Vader.
Shut up, you're just jealous.
It's really strange how our relationship has changed since I've grown up. It's like, he's like my best friend, you know? And I feel like I can talk to him about anything, and that's a good feeling.
Vegas is crazy, y'all.
I mean, it's Vegas, hello. There's lights everywhere. People are there just to have a good time. People are there to be crazy, and you feel that energy. But too much of Vegas, at like 2 or 3 days, you know, is good. Then I'm ready to come back home.
Where's the roller coaster?
We all got together and we rode roller coasters.
That thing right here?
Yeah.
Y'all! I'm scared.
I just love rides. I do. Just the adrenaline, and they're so exciting, and you get to be scared.
Gotta ride it, Rob. That's all there is.
Well, we were really excited about going.
Oh, this is pretty, y'all.
They just shut the ride down. Yeah, the winds are too high.
For security reasons, the winds are too high.
I was bummed, man.
It's unsafe to send somebody up that high in the air, so they shut down.
We got up there, and they're like, turn around. It's just because we walked all the way up there.
Sad.
They're like, you gotta go.
We'll go on the next one. We'll go on the other ride. We'll have fun.
The second ride we went to was at the NASCAR cafe.
Okay, I'm getting nervous now. You think you know, you have no idea.
You're sitting there, and you're not expecting this, but all of a sudden it goes from 0 to 70 miles per hour, and it totally takes you off guard.
I need to calm my ass down.
You're like, whoa! You go forward, and then all of a sudden the ride stops, and it goes backwards. So we rode it like 2 or 3 times.
Oh, we're gonna do it again!
Really queasy when I got finished.
The pictures.
Here we are, wait.
My face was like all like this and stretched out, but it really wasn't. You're going so fast, the wind literally pulls your face back. It's not the most attractive picture in the world, but it's nice to laugh at. And it was definitely the best ride that we went on. I loved it. This is the Diary of Britney Spears. July 29th, 2001.
Y'all, I can't believe I'm about to play basketball!
I got to shoot some hoops.
You're nervous, huh? I can tell.
I don't really get that nervous when I do things, but I was really nervous. I do not know why.
You have fun.
Okay, I know. I wanted to do good.
I just want to make one shot. That's it, just one shot.
That's what I would wish for you.
Wouldn't it be cool if like I made like a 3-pointer or something?
I don't know. Or you slam dunked it.
Felicia, I kind of slam dunked.
Make it out? Yeah.
The two teams that were playing that day were the Days versus the Night. I've known NSYNC for a while. They are so much fun. They are. They're like, when you're with them, you just have a good time, you know, and that's what it's about. They deserve everything that they have right now. Well, Justin live on my team. I didn't know it was gonna have our nickname on our jersey, so when I got him and said Pinky, it was very cute. I have
have a ring that he gave me that I wear on my pinky. So he just ended up calling me Pinky one day, and I started calling him Stinky for some reason. So those were our nicknames.
The warm-up I was on.
Like, I was out there and I was doing my thing and I was shooting, I was making every shot. I was all proud of myself. And then the game starts. And then I throw the ball to the other team. We beat them. We did. We beat them really bad. August 15th, 2001.
Got it? Sure. Thank you. Thank you. I'm Jamie.
Are those extensions or is that your real hair?
It's not real.
Oh, cool.
A lot of times when I go to a lot of places, I'll just put on a hat and a pair of jeans and a big shirt so no one will really recognize me.
Why are you filming me?
When they do recognize me, if it's like one person, I'll totally give them my autograph. But if it's a place where there's a lot of people, I end up feeling kind of bad because once you give one autograph, you end up having to give an autograph to so many people.
He just said, I'm gonna film this girl. Ew.
Justin was off that day, so I wanted him to tag along with me.
Oh yeah.
He's a gentleman. Yes, yes, yes. So, yeah, that was sweet of him. Got out to go get my coffee.
Hey, man, that's what I do.
I'm very lucky. I know. We don't get to see each other that much, so when we do have, like, 2 or 3 days together, I totally soak it up and just try to be with him as much as I can, and I'm probably annoying. I'm, like, up in his grill. The tour starts October 29th, so I have a lot of work to do.
I'm excited.
This tour is definitely going to be so different from anything that I've ever done. Wade Robson is the director for my show. Yeah, he got all the dancers in and he was auditioning them. I haven't danced in a really long time, so the energy that I felt when I walked in there and saw all those dancers, I was like, wow, I can't wait. I got to go up there and watch them from a secret room because we were kind of scared they may be a little nervous if I came and sat down in the front and watched them.
Ooh. Hello!
With this tour, we just want everyone to have their own look and, of course, you know, be able to dance and just do their thing. Another thing is just for them to be really nice people, because you're on the road with these people, it becomes like a family, and if you can't get along with them, then, you know, it's kind of hard. But I trust Wade in that, definitely.
I know! I love this! Here's Sierra!
Y'all are funny. Y'all are really funny, man.
Yeah.
I mean, it's cool, but y'all are like,
oh my God!
I think there was probably about like 200 or 300 people there. And that was the callback.
We're gonna make one more cut and then put whoever's left on tape. So we're almost done.
Ever since I was a little girl, dancing has been such a big part of me and who I am. I love dancing. I do.
This is what class is like. This is what I miss.
It reminded me of dance class. Being on the dance floor, putting each other into groups and everyone just cheering everybody on.
I miss dance class, man.
I was like, I wish I was out there.
Oh, that was awesome.
Touring is one of the best things about what I do. Just the feeling of being out there in front of all those people and them just being able to make them smile. Them being so into what you're doing is very cool. And I'm a performer. I can't get enough of that. I love it. August 18th, 2001. Today I did promos with Jamie Foxx for the MTV Awards, which was a lot of fun. Jamie is very funny.
Watch me now! Oops, I did it again. H to the N-O, H to the V-J. Oops, I did it. What the hell is going on?
He is a funny creature.
So wait, you lay on the ground, you go like...
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, then.
I was acting really silly.
Larry, that's a great move.
Let's do this, man.
Here we go, guys. Everybody to one, please.
Jamie was supposed to be doing rehearsals in the studio because he was supposedly trying to learn some dance moves for being the host for the MTV Awards. And I was supposed to come in and try to help him out. The first take that we did, I wasn't really on with timing, so it was good for me to see that so I could speed it up a little bit.
Yeah, I want this tight as possible. Jamie's doing his moves. I completely hear him in. You say what you're going to say. Keep it quick.
Each one we tried to, you know, bring it to the next level.
Hey, you know, just act stupid.
Okay.
And you can't keep doing stuff like this. You know, they break dance and stuff.
Okay.
First, I'm doing all these, like, really sexy moves.
Yeah, work it out.
Camera eye contact.
And then all of a sudden, I'm like, no, are all the cameras on? And he's like, no. He's like, well, I want to show you the real stuff. And then I just let go, and I act like a complete idiot.
It was a teenage wedding, and the old folks wished him well. You could see that Pierre did truly love the mademoiselle.
Anytime I can act like a total idiot and be silly, I'm up for it. I love being silly like that. I've never been that dorky in front of the camera.
I got big Britney's booty on me. Britney's booty's on me.
I thought it was funny. I hope other people do too. My humor is kind of different though.
That, you know?
August 22nd, 2001. It's just something about the Video Music Awards that, I don't know, everybody watches. It's shocking. You never know what's going to happen. It's live. You never know who's going to wear what the performances are going to be like. Everybody just really lets go. Every time I've gone, the energy is just amazing. It's definitely the funnest award show. Last year's performance was a lot of fun. It was my first time to really just do my thing and express myself. Honestly, I had no idea it was going to be such a big deal with what I had on. I just wanted to be really sparkly and pretty, you know, with my outfit underneath the suit. People thought you could see through it, but you couldn't. I still don't see what the big deal was. As long as I feel comfortable in what I'm wearing, that's what matters, you know? I mean, you can't please everybody. And people are gonna have opinions all day long, but the only opinion I think that matters is the opinion for myself and my family. I'm really excited about this year's performance. It's because it is MTV. It's such a big show. You want to do your best. You want it to be so wonderful. That causes a lot of nervous tension, but I work really good under pressure. From here, we'll have 3 days of rehearsal. Hectic 3 days of rehearsal, and then I'll pull forward. Wade Robson is definitely one of the best choreographers in the world. Seriously, I'm totally not hyping him up enough. He's as nice as he is talented, and that means a lot because there's a lot of people out there that are very hard to work with. I remember the first time that I met him, I was like, wait, he's my age. He's gonna do my tour. And sure enough, he started doing his thing, and I was like, wow. I was really impressed. He's a really good friend of mine, too. I love him.
The song, it's kind of nerve-wracking because nobody has heard the song. It's not even gonna have been on the radio or anything. This is the first time to hear it, and I don't think MTV's ever done that before. The name of it is I'm a Slave for You. I'm really proud of the song. I love it. It's definitely my favorite song I've ever done. People are like, well, what are you gonna do to try and top last year? And I'm like, I don't know. You know what? I just gotta go out there and do my thing. And just, it's not something that, I don't even know if I wanna top last year. It's just, I just wanna do what I feel, and hopefully people will like that. August 25th, 2001. The Britney Spears Foundation, it's for underprivileged kids that go to this camp and that have a love for the arts. They get to work with the best dancing coaches and acting coaches and singing coaches and just enhance their ability to do what they love to do.
But for the photographers, I don't want to let me, when I'm trying to visit the kids, flashes going off 24/7. I just want to know they have their time and the kids have their time.
Right. We have benches put up so they can't even get in your face while you're talking to the kids. They're blocked off.
It's very close to here. So.
They've been acting and singing and dancing and learning hip hop, and it's been fabulous.
I think there's so many kids out there that have, you know, gifts, talents, singing, dancing, or whatever it is, and they don't even know. And for them to be able to have that creative outlet, I think it's very important. They were really excited. I walked into the cafeteria and they were all chilling and hanging out, and they saw me and they're like, hey. I was like, oh, slow down. They all started running. I was like, no, just sit.
Guys, I need you guys to all find a seat, please.
Have you had fun?
Yeah!
Cool.
Are you excited about the show?
Yeah!
It was nice, though. It was very sweet.
That'll wake you up in the morning. Hello.
How do you assure that it's what you want it to be? How do you make sure that this is up to your standards? Are you...
Well, all the acting coaches and dancing coaches and singing coaches are the same ones that I've used recently, so I know that they're in definitely good hands. And I come at the very end of the camp and be able to be entertained to make sure that they're doing what they're supposed to be doing.
Thank you. Okay, you can go back.
They do it for like 2 weeks, and at the very end, I come and they put on a show for me. Their parents were so happy, and they were so happy, and it was their time to shine. They put on skits and sing their little songs. They get out there and they do all types of dancing, modern dancing, hip-hop dancing. But they just have a good time. They feel free to do what they want to do. I just know that when I was younger, there was a time where financially, you know, it was hard for my parents, and it was hard for me to be able to go to, you know, singing lessons sometimes. Kids have so much creative energy and they need to put it somewhere, and I think it's really important to have an organization to fill that. Experiences that happen, that you learn and you grow from them. So I hope I've grown a little bit.
Y'all, the show was amazing. The dance were hilarious.
This summer, it's been kind of crazy, but it's been a lot of fun. It's been a lot of fun. You know, I got to record my album. I got to write and say things that I wanted to say. And it's been cool. It's been a learning experience for me.
Bye, MTV.
as much as I did. So have a good one.
My advice to kids that have the dream to sing or dance or whatever is to keep dreaming. To keep dreaming, and God's given you the talent to sing or dance or whatever it is. Go for it and do it, and never doubt yourself. Never.